Oh, people, come to him. Come to the way, oh, Sultan al-Anbiya, most honored one, and most glorified one, most praised one, in divine presence, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Literally meaning is that wama ana biqari, I don't read and write. But what you want me to read? What you want me to read? What kind of secrets you want me to expose? What a kind of secrets you want me from these three realities to tell human being, to tell my Sahaba, to tell the Ummah, to tell the creation? So what I have to say, I have permission to mention this? And he said, yes, Iqra' bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. Every word in the Holy Quran has a meaning. Not one meaning. Awliya Allah, they go from 12,000 meaning on every letter of the word, of the kalima, any word of Holy Quran. On every letter there is 12,000 up to 24,000 different meanings. And they don't say meanings, they say oceans of meanings. Mm-hmm. Which many scholars, many awliya have written in their life, that we today, you need thousands and thousands and millions of people to understand. I cannot understand what they wrote of these realities. Today there is no more of that caliber. Very few. But of the caliber of the ulama, of the ummah, that they have written for awliya Allah, what they have written of these secrets, it's impossible. بشرى لنا معشر الإسلام إن لنا من العناية غير منهدم. Grand Sheikh used to read it, بشرى لنا معشر الإنسان إن لنا من العناية. العناية هنا هي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ركن غير منهدم. أي that good tidings and good favors and good honors that Allah granted us, O human beings, إِنَّ لَنَا بُشْرَ لَنَا مَحْشَرَ الْإِنسَانِ إِنَّ لَنَا مِنَ الْعِنَايَةِ. We have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us عِنَايَةِ. عِنَايَةِ is the mercy, and the mercy of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we can lean on him. That's what the meaning there, that you cannot lean on anyone except on Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why he is carrying the load of the Ummah on his shoulder and coming to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with that load of Ummah to clean his Ummah in the Day of Judgment, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive them. So, the reality of understanding al-insan al-kamil, the perfect man, is impossible. To understand, you have to be perfect. Perfect can understand perfect. Allah is the absolute perfect. And in his creation. And Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the absolute perfect in as a servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So no one can understand the essence, the reality of that al-buhd. The essence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That essence that no awliya Allah try to enter into that ocean, they cannot. They have to enter through Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and through Prophet to that, if it was given permission to them. And there is a reality of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that no one can understand except Prophet. And awliya Allah, they have realities that they can understand from the reality of Prophet, what Prophet will tell them to know. So it is a, what do you call it?
Hierarchy.
It's a hierarchy. They say no hierarchy. How is there is no hierarchy? Everything there is hierarchy. If there is no hierarchy, we would have been making ascension, Na'raj. But the only one who did Mi'raj is Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So with whom we are holding, if we hold his Mi'raj, we Mi'raj with him. We go with him. So there is hierarchy. From why we ask for ijaza? We come to Shaykh and say, Ya Shaykh, give me an ijaza. He give you an ijaza, a written ijaza, from his Shaykh, and his Shaykh to his Shaykh, and his Shaykh to his Shaykh, until you reach to one of the Ashab al-Nabi, Sahaba al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or Imam al-Arba'a, or 12 Imam. Grandchildren of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or Ashab al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or Imam al-Arba'a, or Ulama. But there is a chain to reach. In reality, there is everything is put like beads. They are in a chain. Your beads like near each other. They connect to each other. But if you cut the thread, string, if you cut it, it falls apart. So don't cut your string to your Shaykh.
Ameen.
Because he will be connecting you all the way to Prophet he directly connect to his Shaykh and his Shaykh to his Shaykh all the way to Prophet. And what is understood from us is what we have to do is to Allah gave us something that very easy to say on the tongue, but it's very heavy in this case. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi.
Subhanallah.
He was mentioning in his dua to make ziyarah to Prophet.
No.
He didn't mention that? That moment, when he mentioned, a meaning came from Mawlana Shaykh, Allah bless his soul. Because I like Shaykh Ali Hussain, because he's Ali, he's Hussain. And we are in the month of Sayyidina Hussain. And Ashura is when Allah gave safety to many prophets. Ma'na ziyara, the meaning of ziyara is to visit someone.
No?
To travel. To travel, even you have to travel from this house to this house is a travel. In order to make ziyarah, to go and visit, and to get the barakah and to get the respect that you need, you go and visit, you'll be honored. All of us, we are guests. Today we are guests. Yesterday we were guests. Every day we are guests. When we are in our prayers, we are guests to Prophet and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we say Allahu Akbar, we are in the ziyarah already. From when we say through the fara'id, obligatory prayers, we are doing ziyarah bayna yadayir rahman. We are in between the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are not seeing, of course you are not seeing, you are veiled. And similarly, when you do sunan, you are in ziyarah of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In kuntum tuhibbun Allah, fattabi'uni. If you want the ziyarah, when we love someone, you want to visit. In kuntum tuhibbun Allah, in kuntum turiduna ziyarah, fattabi'u Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you really want to visit, follow the way of Prophet, because he is the guide for you. I gave him the message, he will guide you, like generals in the army. The top one will give the message to the generals, and they follow with their soldiers. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam guide those who are in positions, and they will deliver the message to the ummah. Prophet guide us, in kuntum tuhibbuna Allah fattabi'uni yuhibbukum, follow me, Allah will love you. If you follow Prophet, means anything you want to go to be accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to make ziyarah to Prophet. You cannot come. فَاتَّبِعُوا مُحَمَّدٍ. You cannot come by yourself. You have to take him with you. How? Allah is not waiting for you, or Prophet is not waiting for you to do it, because they know you are not going to do it. They know we are not going to do it. We say, Ya Rabbi, irzukna ziyara, the visit, but we are not doing it. They will do it for you. How? The ayah. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ يَدْرَوْا أَنفُسَهُمْ جَاءُوكَ الظُّلُمْ ظُلْمَان ظُلُمْ لِنَفْسِكْ وَظُلُمْ لِغَيْرِكْ. You make oppression to yourself, you oppress yourself, or you oppress the others. If you oppress yourself, means you have to, by ma'asiyah, doing a sin, you are oppressing yourself, your soul, that Allah gave to you a pure soul, the realities, the three realities that Allah gave to you, you are trying to oppress them by doing masiyah. Although you cannot put them down, because Allah is protecting these three realities. وَلَكَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمْ. We have honored the human being with these three realities. No one can take them, but you oppress them, you try to knock on their door, on these lights, try to do the mafia. So, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not allow it. When Iblis did that whisper in the ear of Adam alayhi salam, Allah forgave Sayyidina Adam. And he made Iblis to look bad, that you are after him, I forgive him. Allah, what you can do? Allah. If Allah wants to forgive the whole Ummah, Allah, what Iblis can do in the day of judgment?
He's not going to do anything.
So, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِنْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ, means when they are oppressor to themselves, when they are in ma'asiyah, they come to you, means they be put the ma'asiyah behind them and come for ziyarah. وهذه هي معنى الهجرة. إنما الأعمال بالنيات فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. So معنى الهجرة is according to your intention. If your intention is to Allah and His Prophet, that is the real hijrah. So when you leave the zulm of yourself or zulm of the people, when you stop oppressing yourself and oppressing the people, then you begin to go on the road of إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ فَهِجْرَتُهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. You are going in the direction of ziyarah to Prophet and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As soon as you do the ma'asiyah, immediately as Muslims, because we know what is ma'asiyah and what is hasanah. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً. We know what is the حَسَنَةً and we know what is the مَعْصِيَةً. When you do حَسَنَةً, you're happy. When you do مَعْصِيَةً, what would happen? You are not happy. Immediately, anyone can figure that. When you do something wrong, you know it's wrong. You ask astaghfir, your spirit, your soul, your body, your heart, your mind will say astaghfir. But that is not enough. So when you are coming from وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ يَضَّرَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ جَاءُوكَ. When they are oppressor to themselves, they come to you, Ya Muhammad. So when you come to someone knocking at his door, what he will do?
Will open.
He is present. He will open the door for you. Means he is present for you. He's there. So as soon as a human being say Astaghfirullah, the Ruhaniyatul Nabi is appearing. To be present. This is the meaning. Ja'uka fastaghfirullah. Ja'uka, and they come to you asking forgiveness. So when we come to someone asking forgiveness, we are going to hear the answer, is not? واستغفر لهم الرسول. And Prophet will make istighfar on our behalf. If we have no veins, we can see. The reality of Prophet, the Harahamiya and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. According to your capacity, you might smell a nice smell, you might see light appear, or you might feel something, goosebumps, or you feel something strange, that you feel happiness in yourself. Or you cry, or whatever. So that is the presence of Prophet. So anyone who really wants to come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has to come through the guidance of Prophet. And Allah is explaining to us, to come to the presence of Prophet is to live, to do hijrah from ma'siyah to hasan. To rewards. So how to get the rewards to reach the ziyarah and Allah happy with you and Prophet happy with you is by repenting. So what you have to say?
Astaghfirullah.
Astaghfirullah. For sure that nazar of Prophet is observing us. He is hadirun wa nadirun. He is present and he is looking. You might see, you might not see, but he is seeing that he will take you to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So al-hijrah, that's why awliya Allah they move from the place they are born to a place to be buried, not in the same place. It's Sunnatul Anbiya. That's why you see Anbiya are in different areas. Prophet left Mecca, came to Medina. Mecca is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Sunnatullah subhanahu wa Sunnatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to be in a different place when you are getting to be buried from your main place to another place. That's why awliya Allah, you see them traveling and they being buried in different places. Like Mu'addin ibn Arab. He was in Morocco and he was buried where?
Damascus.
In Damascus, in Sham. Like Abu Yazid al-Bastam. They don't want to be buried in the same place. They want the hijrah. The real meaning of the hijrah is I left dunya
to come to another city, left my dunya behind, and coming to other city to be buried in that soil. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us and guide us to understand the reality of the teaching of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the teaching of Holy Quran, the teaching of Islam. Today, in this era, it looks like so many events happening, guiding, showing us direction of something big is going to come. And those who cannot see that, might be they are blind. But too many killings. Yesterday or today, 140 children, women and men were being killed in Aleppo by these planes for bombarding. Just today. And Prophet ﷺ said, Harj wal Marj, too much killing is going to be. And this is what we are seeing. Why we don't need any more evidence, although Prophet mentioned hundreds of evidences, what's predicted, what's going to happen. That would be one of them, or the biggest, is too much killings on earth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us.
Ameen.
And protect our children.
Ameen.
And our ummah.
Ameen.
From the hand of shaitan.
Ameen.
And keep us, Ya Rabbi, on the way of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
Ameen.
Following his footsteps.
Ameen.
Wa min Allahi tawfiq wa karamatil fatiha.